I'm a travel vlogger. I'm currently in Meghalaya, the capital city of Meghalaya, Shillong. I'm backpacking across Northeast India for the next few days, and this is the beginning of my journey. So before getting here, I actually landed at Guwahati yesterday, and from Guwahati I took a private cab all the way to Shillong and stayed here for a night. I'm here at Monsoon Hotel at the moment. It's not an excessively nice hotel, but it was a convenient place after getting here, so I stayed here for a night. And today I think I'm going to be heading out of Shillong to Cherrapunji. So it's only 9 a.m. and shops to khuli nahi hai, but I'm looking for a place where I can eat at least. But a lot of you are always ask me in comments, what month am I traveling in and how's the weather like? So this time I thought that I'll give you guys an idea at the start of the video. So I'm currently traveling in the month of June, and June is not the most ideal time for traveling, but I made a plan on whim that I just wanted to visit Northeast India, so here I am. Apart from that, the weather is quite pleasant actually right now. Bahut hi mild temperature hai. In fact, I'm wearing a light jacket too at the moment. So I don't know if you guys already know this, but I'm a big fan of eating fruits whenever I'm traveling, especially for breakfast. So I just came across this shop that's selling some fruits, so I picked up some apple. Also, looks like I have a date today. I get carried away. I've been living too fast and end up sleeping too late. Envisions swearing off on me. Yay, feminism. I've been learning to stop. I've been learning to wait. So it's finally time for me to leave from Shillong to Cherrapunji. I am leaving with this gentleman here, who is a taxi driver, and he says that we're also going to be doing some sightseeing along the way, and also he'll be dropping me to Cherrapunji at a hotel. That the taxi driver has stopped at is called Mao Potok Valley. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly because I'm generally bad at pronouncing names, but it's quite gorgeous. So I think mentioned nahi kiya pehle, but recently I got this new camera. It's a Panasonic GH5, and ever since we stopped here, I took out this camera and I've been having a lot of fun. I'm using it with a 25mm lens. For all of you who don't understand camera jargon, I know this might be a little boring, but I'm really excited about using this camera because bahut acha blurry background and soft focus wale shots aate hain isse. So perfect for adding some cinematic touch to the vlog. And you're going to be seeing some of those shots right about now. Okay, real quick, I'm at the next destination. This place is a... I knew Cherrapunji because of these waterfalls, and it's unfortunate that it's raining now. Oh shit, it's raining. Ah! Oh no, kafi barish ho rahi hai. Those were no Kalikai falls that we couldn't visit because bahut tez barish hone lag gayi aur abhi bhi bahut tez barish ho rahi hai. Ab jaake lag raha hai Ramin Cherrapunji, the wettest place on planet earth. Okay guys, no Kalikai falls to nahi ho paya kyunki barish ho rahi thi, but in 10 minutes barish subsided, and now where I'm standing, this place is called Seven Sisters Waterfall, and I don't know what to do because it's just so pretty. I want to flip my camera, of course. Let's flip the camera. About time. When it was only a- Okay, final stop for today is Sohra, and after visiting all those places that the cab driver took me to, I found myself a homestay. It's a really nice, cute little place out here where I'm going to be staying tonight. I think the time is around 4 p.m. right now. I don't know what the exact time is because my phone is not on me, There's no phone signal because of a recent curfew that happened in Shillong. So the entire internet connectivity across the state of Meghalaya is currently off. So since my internet was not working, I thought I'll just leave my phone behind. I am just with my camera right now and I've changed into my workout gear because I thought I'll get some run. And the weather is perfect, A grade, and roads are impeccable, really pretty. And bahut hi kam traffic hai. So, great time to catch up on some workout on the go. This has to be my favorite cup of chai in a while with a view. I'm eating here at a cafe called Halari, and there are quite a lot of restaurants here, and most of them serve predominantly like northeastern cuisine, khasi food, and mostly Chinese kind of cuisine. Another noteworthy point is that there's a slight nip in the air, there's a mild breeze blowing, so the weather is legend. But I think by the time it's nighttime, it's gonna get a little cold. So in case you're traveling here, be prepared and carry something warm along with you. And do carry Odomos or similar mosquito repellents because you're gonna face a lot of mosquitoes here. I just woke up right now. It's around 6 a.m. I have to head to another place today. But as soon as I woke up, I noticed that I can hear constant pitter-pattering of water outside. Looks like it's been raining all night. Okay, now that the rain has subsided, I'm heading to the next destination. Now, Northeast India and Meghalaya in particular is really famous for the Living Roots Bridge and the double-decker bridge. And I think even when I started researching about Meghalaya, the first thing that popped into the pictures was the double-decker roots bridge. So I am heading to that place currently. And to head to that place from Sohra, you have to go to Tirna. Now, Tirna is just a short cab ride away, and it's just 15 kilometers apparently. So the charge for the cab is around 300 to 400 rupees, and I'm going to be taking that cab to head to Tirna now. So mausam ke halaat abhi kuch aise hain, and here's the cab that I'm going to be taking all the way to Tirna, and from there we're going to be hiking down to a village called Nongriyat and staying there overnight. Now I don't know whether or not we'll be able to find a place to stay there because you pretty much just have to show up there and book a place. Pre-booking is probably an option, but I haven't pre-booked, so I'm just going to go get there and see if I can get to that place. Also, the weather doesn't look really nice, but I don't know. I think I'm just going to wing it and see what happens. And that's what backpacking is all about, right? So guys, that what you see in front of me is Bangladesh. Okay, I'm at the start point of the hike towards Nongriyat, and here you will also find people who will be ready to carry your luggage for you, or you can get these sticks for yourself in case you're interested. I am also wearing a poncho because it's kind of drizzling and I don't want to get my stuff wet, especially because I'm carrying cameras. Another point that I'd like to mention is that the cab till over here, you have to get a private cab mandatorily because there are no shared cabs that come till here. If you're coming from Shillong to Sohra, of course you'll get shared cabs, which cost really economical. They're like 70 rupees per seat per person. So they're quite economical. Also, I did not take one because I took a private cab on my way till here because I wanted to shoot on the way. But on my way back, I'm thinking of getting a private cab. I'm thinking of getting a shared cab on my way back so that I can save some cost. So apparently these are like 3200 steps that I have to be climbing down all the way to the village. And the village that we're going to be reaching after the climb down is going to be a quite remote village, so no phone signals over there. Is it, take it, we can't fake the fall. It's not a race
at all. It was a wake-up call.
So I just came across some fellow travelers over here and I was asking how long do I have to go. So how long for the single bridge?
Single bridge about 1.2 kilometers.
1.2 kilometers, yeah. And double route bridge?
2.5.
So yeah, that's how long we have to go still. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, trek update so far. I've done about 30 minutes of stairs and there's 30 more minutes left to the village and it's quite humid. Like, I'm sweating like a pig already. So for those of you who are coming here, this is kind of like a strenuous stretch of climbing down and also going to be really strenuous climbing up again. So in case you're not very physically fit, refrain from coming here. Also, if you have an injury, do not come here because it's a lot of stairs. In those vacant spaces, it wasn't our fault. We were torn apart and now we can't let go. This is a test of the human spirit. When it was only us. Okay, I am fully exhausted by now. But the village is not very far away, and you know, I was wrong when I said earlier today that if you're not physically fit, don't come here, because this hike may not be enjoyable for somebody who's not physically fit. Maybe, in fact, even I'm not as physically fit, but you know how the saying goes, that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Now, I don't remember who said that. Meko laga cool lagega agar main kahungi to. So, in case you know who said it, let me know in comments below, because mera internet connection to chal nahi raha hai. But it's worth coming here. It's fun. And I'm sure the Living Roots Bridge is going to be completely and utterly worth it too. I've entered the area of the double-decker bridge, and apparently after this bridge there's a really nice homestay here. So before entering this area, and you can also see like people enjoying the natural showers and everything, I'm already so excited about jumping into that pool. So instead of that, you can cross over the bridge and then you can go for another homestay. And also at the entry, you have to declare all your cameras and you have to basically make sure that you pay for it. Forgot to mention earlier, guys, but I'm at this homestay called Chali's Homestay. It's walking distance from the Living Roots Bridge here. So I just had a natural shower at the Living Roots Bridge, and that was super convenient because I could just walk back to this homestay. And dinner also is going to be served tonight at this place itself. This is Bibimbap. Village. What a trip this was. We are a group of 9 and we had the most satisfying time at Chali's aboard. It was wonderfully peaceful and serene, and we would definitely recommend others to visit this place. Lots of good wishes and a big thank you. I was lost when I came here, then got lost literally in the forest, but when I found myself, I found more than my physical self. Good stuff. Good morning, you all. So honestly, if you're living in a forest, the novelty of it wears off quite quickly. I know everybody's excited about staying in a forest initially, but when you actually stay in one, there are bugs, there are mosquitoes. But I'm so glad that I was carrying Odomos along with me. So two things that you should definitely carry if you're coming here and if you want to stay in the forest especially. One is a poncho, because it can start raining at any point of time. And second is Odomos, because there are just so many bugs here. It's crazy. I think I wouldn't have survived the night had I not had a mosquito repellent with me. So right now, since I'm living so close to the double-decker bridge and also the waterfall, I'm going to head there. It's probably 5:30 a.m. and everybody around here seems like they're fast asleep. And also, it's beginning to get really misty. Does not look like ideal weather to go ahead and go to Rainbow Falls from here. But I'm still going to make the most of whatever I have on me right now. Thank you. Alright, 3200 steps, the trek is over and it's 8:30 a.m. So if any one of you is interested in coming for this trek, don't miss out on it, because if your girl can do it, so can you. But before you leave, I have something really important to say to you. So if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, that share button. Share it with your friends who are planning a trip to Meghalaya maybe. And let me know in comments which was your favorite part of the video. Maybe it was these falls. And subscribe to my channel, don't forget to do that. And I'll see you next time in another vlog. Bye bye.